Hi students, welcome to our class. Today we are going to discuss about the problems related to the chapter electrostatics. Okay, our first question. What is the force between two charged spheres having charges 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 coulomb and 3 into 10 raised to minus 7 coulomb placed 30 centimeter apart in air? Okay. That's our question. Two charges are given. Okay. We can take that charges as Q1 and Q2. Q1, Q2. What about Q1? Q1 is equal to 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 coulomb. And Q2 is equal to 3 into 10 raised to minus 7 coulomb. Okay. And they are placed at 30 centimeter apart. The distance also given. Distance r is equal to 30 centimeter, that is 30 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. Okay, we want to find out what about the force between the two charged spheres. We want to find out the force. Okay, what about the equation for the force? We know that the equation for the force is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into q1 q2 divided by r square. Okay. F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q1 Q2 divided by R square. Okay, now we can substitute the values of Q1, Q2 and R to this equation. Then F is equal to, what about the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 is equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9. Okay. 9 into 10 raised to 9 into, what about Q1? Q1 is equal to 2 into 10 raised to minus 7. 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 into, what about Q2? 3 into 10 raised to minus 7. 3 into 10 raised to minus 7 divided by, what about R square? It's equal to 30 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. 30 into 10 raised to minus 2 the whole square, R square. It's equal to 9 into 2 into 3 into 10 raised to 9 into 10 raised to minus 14 divided by, okay, 900 into 10 raised to minus 4. Minus 2 the whole square is equal to minus 4. Okay, 9 cancel to 900, it's equal to 100. Again, 2 cancel to 100, it's equal to 50. That's equal to 3 into 10 raised to 9 into 10 raised to minus 14. It's cancelled. It's equal to 10 raised to minus 5. Okay, 10 raised to minus 5 divided by 50 into 10 raised to minus 4. Okay. Minus 4 cancel to minus 5. That is equal to minus 1. Okay. 3 divided by 50 into 10 raised to minus 1. Okay. On solving this value, we get into 1 by 5 is equal to 0.2, then 1 by 50 is equal to 0.02 into 10 raised to minus 1. That is equal to 3 into 0.02 means 0.06. Okay, 0.06 into 10 raised to minus 1. That is equal to 0.006. Okay. Therefore, the force is equal to, F is equal to 6 into 10 raised to minus 3 newton. Okay, what about the force between 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 coulomb and 3 into 10 raised to minus 7 coulomb? It's equal to 6 into 10 raised to minus 3 newton. Okay, our second question. Electrostatic force on a small sphere of charge 0.4 microcoulomb due to another smaller sphere of charge -0.8 microcoulomb in air is 0.2 newton. What is the distance between two spheres? We want to find out the distance between two spheres. Charges are given. First charge Q1 is equal to 0.4 microcoulomb. Okay. And what about Q2? Q2 is equal to -0.8 microcoulomb. And the force between them is equal to, force F is equal to 0.2 newton. Okay. Force is given. Two charges are given. We want to find out the distance R. Okay. How can we find out the distance R? For this, we can use the same equation. F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q1 Q2 divided by R square. Okay. F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q1 Q2 divided by R square. What about the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0? It's equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9. What about Q1? Q1 is equal to 0.4 into 10 raised to minus 6. Micro means 10 raised to minus 6. Okay. Into. What about Q2? Q2 is equal to -0.8 into 10 raised to minus 6. Okay. 0.8 into 10 raised to minus 6. Micro means 10 raised to minus 6. Divided by R square. Okay. We want to find out R. Force is given here. What about the value of force? Force is equal to 0.2 newton. Okay. We can rearrange from here. R square is equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9 into 0.4 into 0.8. That is equal to 0.8 into 4. 32 into 10 raised to minus 12 divided by 0.2. Okay. 10 raised to 9 cancel to 10 raised to minus 12. It's equal to 10 raised to minus 3. Okay. 0.2 cancel to 0.32. That's equal to 1.6. Okay. Therefore, 9 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 3. R square is equal to this much. And it's equal to 9 into 16 into 10 raised to minus 4. Okay. This is R square. From this we can find out R. R is equal to, by taking square root. Square root of 9 is 3. Square root of 16 is 4. Square root of 10 raised to minus 4 is 10 raised to minus 2. It's equal to 12 into 10 raised to minus 2. That's equal to 12 centimeter. Okay. But what about the distance between Q1 and Q2? It's equal to 12 centimeter. Okay. Our first question is, what about the distance between the two spheres? The distance between them is equal to 12 centimeters. Okay. Now we want to find out what is the force on the second sphere due to first sphere. Okay. What about that force? That force is already given in the question. It's equal to 0.2 newton. Okay. Here two charges Q1 and Q2 separated by a distance R. Then what about the force between these two charges? It's equal to 0.2 newton. Okay. What about force acting on Q1 on Q2? It's equal to 0.2. What about force acting on Q2 on Q1? And it's also same. It's equal to 0.2 newton. Okay. And which type of force is this? It is attractive or repulsive? Okay, here it is attractive because first charge is positive and the second charge is negative. So, there will be a force of attraction. Okay. Our third question. Two points are the 3 microcoulomb and the minus 3 microcoulomb are located 20 cm apart in vacuum. What is the electric field at the midpoint O of the line AB joining the two charges? Here we have two charges, 3 microcoulomb and minus 3 microcoulomb. 3 microcoulomb and minus 3 microcoulomb, which are separated by a distance 20 cm apart. Okay, 20 cm apart. What is the electric field at the midpoint O of the line joining? Okay, here at the midpoint, what about the electric field at this midpoint? Okay, midpoint O of the line joining the two charges. Okay, here to find out the intensity of electric field at this point O, we want to place a unit positive charge here. Okay, then what about the distance between 3 microcoulomb and plus 1 microcoulomb? It's equal to 10 cm. Here also equal to 10 cm. Okay, then 3 microcoulomb will repel plus 1 coulomb of charge. Okay, both of them are same type of charge, so there will be a force of repulsion, and the force corresponding to that electric field is given in this direction. That is E1. What about here? Here minus 3 microcoulomb. Minus 3 microcoulomb attract this positive 1 coulomb of charge, and the field corresponding to that force is E2, and it is also in the same direction. Minus 3 attract this unit positive charge. Okay, both the fields are in the same direction. What about the net electric field? The net electric field is equal to E1 plus E2. What about the value of E1? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into. Okay, this is due to first charge, so we can write it as Q1 divided by R square. Okay, R1 square plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into. What about the second charge? It is taken as Q2 divided by R2 square. Okay. Now we can substitute its value. 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 is equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9. What about Q1? Q1 is equal to 3 microcoulomb. That is 3 into 10 raised to minus 6. Micro means 10 raised to minus 6. Divided by R1 square. That is 10 centimeter square. 10 into 10 raised to minus 2 the whole square. Okay. Plus. What about 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0? 9 into 10 raised to 9. Into what about Q2? It is minus 3 microcoulomb. But we consider only the magnitude of that charge. That is 3 into 10 raised to minus 6. Divided by what about the distance? 10 into 10 raised to minus 2 the whole square. Okay. From these values, it is very clear that both the values are same. So we can take 2 times. Okay. 2 times 2 into 9 into 10 raised to 9 into 3 into 10 raised to minus 6 divided by what about 100, 10 square is equal to 100. 100 into 10 raised to minus 4. Minus 2 the whole square is equal to minus 4. Okay, on cancelling this, 10 raised to minus 4 cancel to 10 raised to minus 6, that's equal to 10 raised to minus 2. 100 cancel to 10 raised to 9, it's equal to 10 raised to 7. Okay, 9 into 3, 27. 27 into 2 is equal to 54. Therefore, 54 into 10 raised to 5. 10 raised to 7 into 10 raised to minus 2 is equal to 10 raised to 5. Okay, this much Newton per coulomb is the electric field at this point O. Okay, when unit positive charge is placed at the center. Okay. What about our second question? If a negative test charge of magnitude 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 9 coulomb is placed at this point, what is the force experienced by this test charges? Okay, we want to replace plus 1 coulomb of charge by 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 9 coulomb. Okay, 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 9 coulomb charge. What about the sign? It is negative. Okay. Then what about the force experienced here?
Now, 3 microcoulomb and minus 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 9 coulomb, there will be a force of attraction. Okay, and that attractive force is in this direction because both of them are unlike charges. Attractive force is represented as F1. What about here? Minus 3 microcoulomb repels this minus 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 9 coulomb because they are like charges. Okay, what about that repulsive force? And it is in this direction, it is taken as F2. Both these forces are in the same direction. So what will happen there? What about the net force? Net force is equal to F net is equal to F1 plus F2. Okay. What about the equation for the force? Force F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q1 Q2 divided by R square. Okay. Here this charge is taken as Q1, this charge is taken as Q2, and what about this charge? It is taken as Q3. Okay, then first force is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 divided by R square. What about the second force? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q2 Q3 divided by R square. Okay, what about 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0? It's equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9 into what about Q1? Q1 is equal to 3 microcoulomb, 3 into 10 raised to minus 6 into what about Q2? Q2 is equal to minus 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 9, but we consider only the magnitude of the charge, 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 9 divided by what about the distance? 10 centimeter, that is 10 into 10 raised to minus 2 the whole square, plus again 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 is equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9. What about Q2? Q2 is equal to 1.5. Like here we consider only the magnitude, therefore minus 9 into what about Q3? Q3 is equal to minus 3 microcoulomb. Here 3 into 10 raised to minus 6. We consider only the magnitude. Then what about the distance? It's equal to 10 into 10 raised to minus 2 the whole square. From these values, it is very clear that both these values are same. So we can write 2 times. Okay. 2 times 2 into 9 into 10 raised to 9 into 3 into 10 raised to minus 6 into 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 9 divided by 100 into 10 raised to minus 4. Okay, now we can cancel 10 raised to minus 4 to 10 raised to minus 6, that is 10 raised to minus 2. 100 to 10 raised to 9, that is equal to 10 raised to 7. Okay, what about the remaining term? 9 into 2, 18. 18 into 3 into 1.5, that is 4.5 into 10 raised to 7 into 10 raised to minus 2, that is 10 raised to 5. 10 raised to 5 into 10 raised to minus 9, it's equal to 10 raised to minus 4. Okay, then on multiplication, 18 into 4.5, it's equal to 81. 81 into 10 raised to minus 4. What about its unit? It is Newton. Therefore, 81 into 10 raised to minus 4, Newton. Okay. Our fourth question is, a system of two charges, 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 7 coulomb and minus 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 7 coulomb, located at the point 00 minus 15 centimeter and 00 plus 15 centimeter, respectively. Find the total charge and electric dipole moment of the system. Okay, here the two charges are placed in along the z axis. 00 minus 15 centimeter and 00 plus 15 centimeter means, what about the coordinate? That charges are arranged on the z axis. Okay, so we can take this as the z axis. Z axis, minus z axis, and this one is plus z axis. Okay. Two charges are arranged, that is 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 7 And here it's equal to minus 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 7. Okay. Here two equal and opposite type of charges separated by a certain distance. And what about this distance? It is equal to 15 centimeter. And here it's equal to 15 centimeter. Because this point is minus 15. Okay. And this point is plus 15. Okay. Here two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance. So we can call it as dipole. Okay. And then find the total charge. What about the total charge? Net charge is equal to. Net charge is equal to Q1 plus Q2. What about Q1? 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 7. Plus what about Q2? Minus 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 7. Then what about the net force acting there? Net force is equal to 0. Okay. Then we want to find out what about the electric dipole moment. What about dipole moment? Dipole moment is equal to one of the charge into distance between them. Okay. What about one of the charge? One of the charge is 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 7. And what about the distance between them? Distance between these two charges is equal to 15 plus 15 is equal to 30. 30 centimeter. That is 30 into 10 raised to minus 2. Okay. 2L means the distance between the two charges. That is 15 plus 15. That is equal to 30. Okay. And it's equal to 2.5 into 3. It is 7.5. Then 2.5 into 30 is 75. 75 into 10 raised to minus 10 raised to minus 7 into 10 raised to minus 2 is 10 raised to minus 9. Okay. Then what about the dipole moment? Dipole moment is 75 into 10 raised to minus 9. What about its unit? Its unit is coulomb meter. Okay. But dipole moment, okay, our fifth question is, an electric dipole with a dipole moment 4 into 10 raised to minus 9 coulomb meter is aligned 30 degree with the direction of uniform electric field of magnitude 5 into 10 raised to 4 newton per coulomb. Calculate the magnitude of torque acting on the dipole. Okay, we want to find out the torque. Okay, torque. What about the equation for the torque? Torque tau is equal to PE sin theta. Okay, what about the terms given here? An electric dipole with a dipole moment is given. What about dipole moment? Dipole moment P is equal to 4 into 10 raised to minus 9 coulomb meter. That is given. And at an angle, it is aligned at an angle 30 degree. Angle is given, angle theta is equal to 30 degree with a uniform electric field. Okay, the angle between dipole moment and uniform electric field is 30 degree. And that electric field of magnitude, okay, electric field is also given. Electric field is equal to 5 into 10 raised to 4 newton per coulomb. Now we can substitute that. Okay, what about P? 4 into 10 raised to minus 9 into electric field 5 into 10 raised to 4 into sine 30. Okay, it's equal to 4 into 5 is equal to 20. 20 into 10 raised to minus 5. Sine 30 is equal to 1 by 2. Then what about its value? 10. 10 into 10 raised to minus 5. Then what about the torque acting on the dipole? Torque acting on the dipole is equal to 10 into 10 raised to minus 5. And what about its unit? Its unit is Newton meter. Okay. Unit of torque is Newton meter. So, it's Newton meter. I think this topic is clear for you. If you like this video, please subscribe and enable the bell button.